sorry for the weird angle, but kind of driving and thinking about mental health. Have my own issues like most people do. I take medication for clinical depression and anxiety. It's not a big deal. A lot of people have their things, like I said. It's difficult because so many people have had thoughts or feelings that they didn't really know how to categorize or, you know, what to do with those thoughts or things like that. And people don't admit it a lot of times because, you know, either you're not believed or people just think, oh, well, you know. I think a lot of that comes from people's own fears that, you know, they think, well, you know, I was sad one time and I got over it, and, you know, which is great. I mean, that's great. But it's not always easy when it's something deeper and more clinical. It's just strange because I can be having the greatest experiences in my life, like last fall planning for my wedding. You know, it was awesome. I was finally getting married to the person I love and things were going great. I mean, it was really, I mean, there was nothing specific that I could say, this is really bothering me, but I was just sad all the time and I couldn't figure out why. And that's kind of what depression can do to you. You're just sad. And, you know, I'm trying to think of what to compare it to as far as a feeling you have where you don't really have like a catalyst, something that caused it, but it's just there. Sorry, I'm driving, as you can see. So I set the camera up where I did so that I can just drive and talk as if you're sitting next to me. I guess too, like when you're depressed like that, when it's kind of a new feeling for you, clinically, like when it gets to that point, not just, you know, something really has happened and you're having a hard time getting through it, which is bad enough. It's still really hard. But when that becomes more chronic or more clinical, it's hard to recognize too, you know, like you go in the sunshine. I mean, I drive to work 30 minutes each way, and a lot of those days are sunny, even in the winter, right? Winter's really hard because you've got shorter days, but I'm in the vehicle and the sun's shining. So you think, you know, get out, get in the sun, blah, blah, blah. I know it's not the same as being actually outdoors, but it's not like I'm sitting in the house being moody, whatever. And again, I think it's just hard for people to realize or to admit, I'm sorry, that this has gotten to this point, right, in their lives where they can't just say, okay, I'm gonna go for a walk, I'm gonna, you know, watch my favorite show, I'm gonna, whatever it is for them that kind of lifts their mood, or they do those things and nothing works. They still have that deep underlying sadness. But sometimes you just need that little different thing that's going to kick that for you. And sometimes it is medication. And there's nothing wrong with that. It's not like, and even Like, I was going to say, it's not like in the old days where you're grinning idiot all day. But the thing is, even at that point, like, even way back then, that's the medication they had. It got such a bad name because it wasn't regulated as well as it is now, where I can take the meds I take and I can still be sad, I can still be angry, I can still be upset, I can be happy, of course. And, you know, I'm not just sitting there smiling and laughing, giggling at everything. It makes a difference. You know, the serotonin levels in your brain get more equalized and better for you and for your brain and what you need. Trick with that, though, is that a lot of this medication can take up to 3-4 weeks before you can really tell. It's not like, you know, an Advil where it goes in your bloodstream, ta-da, yay, I feel better, usually. But it's actually chemicals in your brain, right, that need to build up in there and keep your mind balanced. So it's tricky. A lot of people, because too, when you're first taking those medications, a lot of times you get, like, you feel sort of weird, or you get, like, your brain kind of, all of a sudden you're just sitting there, and all of a sudden it goes, it's like somebody, like, stuck a vibrator on your head for a second, right? People don't always get that, but that happens, or you're kind of spontaneously dizzy or whatever. But I mean, what would you expect, right? But you stick through it, and all of a sudden you're like, wow, you know, I kind of feel not too bad. And actually, I didn't feel too bad yesterday either, you know? And it's sort of like that. It's not within a few weeks you're like, yay, let's party. So I don't really know the purpose of all this is, and I don't even know if, you know, that stigma is really ever going to get better. It's like the problem with a lot of illnesses that aren't quite physical, where you can't be like, yeah, okay, that person's got a broken arm, or that person has a cold, you know? You can't always see it. Usually you can't see it. So it leads people to be skeptical, especially if it's a different class of society than their own. So people are more, and I hate that because nobody likes classes, but let's face it, it's there, you know. And anybody that knows me knows that I'm gonna sit down and have dinner with homeless people just as easily as I'll sit down and have dinner with somebody that has 4 homes. I mean, I don't care if you're a good person, if you're, you deserve that type of respect until you prove me otherwise, you know? So I don't care. Do what you want. Be who you are. Be the best person you can be, if possible, you know? So I don't know. Like I said, just random thoughts, and I just hope that the more of these types of videos that come out, that more and more people are going to realize that it's not such a horrible thing as far as social acceptance. You know, you can say, I'm in this funk and I can't get out of it, you know? And I know people don't know how to respond, so they'll be like, well, try this or try that. Don't get mad. People don't understand, you know? People just want to say something to help. They want to try and help. You know, just because they're saying, well, you know, if you eat ice cream and watch a funny movie, you're going to feel better. Even though, no, not if it's real good depression, not good, sorry, real deep depression, you know. But maybe there was times where they were really sad, and to them that's really, really sad or upset. And that's something that helped them. It doesn't mean they're being insensitive or they don't get it, or because you see a lot of that things too. People just tell me to smile and go for a walk and I'll feel better. And what do they know, and who do they think they are? Well, they think there's someone who wants to help and to them, that's something that helps. It doesn't mean they don't get it. I mean, sorry. I guess they don't, but not in an insensitive way. You know, I don't know. Am I making sense? Anyway, I guess I should stop for now.